Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to Pokemon Insurgents. Doing a little back-to-back, old lady, where are you supposed to be cleaning this stuff over here? Welcome back to Pokemon Insurgents. Okay. So how should we take this? Start with this room. Welcome to Sonata Hills, youngster. There aren't many folks here, but do try to be quiet. We don't want to make much of a racket. Have you not noticed that the power's gone out? Shh, my patient's trying to sleep. And don't go rifting through the things on his table. They just don't belong to you. He would want me to have them. Random Ultra Ball. Alright, I need to be a little more careful with my speed up. Empty. Hi there. Most people hospitalized don't stay here too long. We use the healing abilities of Pokemon to speed up their recovery. That is a very good idea. What are you? An escape rope. I wonder if I can go back to the Rural Islands. I was just dismissed from the hospital yesterday, so I'm just packing my things up. I hope I didn't leave anything behind. Like a rare candy. Do you want it back? Nope, okay. Poof, get out of the bed. We gotta go. Thank you. Upstairs. Man's asleep in his bed. Regular Pokeball. There's not a lot of people in these hospital rooms, which is good. I used to live in Agate Village in the Ori region. It's a beautiful place, but not nearly as quiet as Sonata, which is rather ironic given its name. Thanks for the repel, old man. There's a man lying here sleeping. I'll take the Burn Heal and the Great Ball. That goes downstairs. I assume I have to go into the basement. Hyper Potion. Nobody. A trainer. I remember those days well. I'll have you know, I was one of the best. Why don't you have yourself my TM on the table? It was way helpful back then. It should help you as well. Dragon Pulse. That is a pretty good one. Okay, so that's everybody upstairs and downstairs, so to the basement. You again, from the Suntouch Gym, right? Pleased to see you again. Harmony, you too, Neko, Nora. My name's Tane, if you don't remember. I'm part of Perfection. Don't worry, I didn't forget. Didn't you, slap a child and try to kidnap, Reshiram? You, at the back. I don't know why you're tampering with our power, but you better start explaining. Don't worry, Harmony, we'll turn the power back on. We just want to talk to you, that's all. Ryukra? Ryukra, what are you doing? Why are you here? I want to make a deal with you, Harmony. A deal with the power source to the hospital. Are you actually blackmailing me with the lives of the people here? Ryukra, what happened to you? You used to be so... I have the power cord. Stop talking. Thank you. That's right, it is me. It has been a while. I'm not the person you knew anymore. I'm the leader of the Perfection Cult now. As for why I'm here, I was trying to find you. You run the hospital here, right? You have access to all the patients in the building. We want access to the room containing the patient, Maldi. It's my father's room, Ryuka. There's no chance I'm letting you near him, and you know it. Thought you might say that. We actually have your father's best interest at heart, believe it or not. We know he's sick, we know what his condition is. Let us help you. We can both get what we want here. I'll put the power back on like you want, then we'll go to Maldi's room on the top floor, and we can talk. Fine, whatever, just hurry up. People's lives are at stake here. Very well. Now, follow me. You used to be so different. What? Who's this Maldi? More importantly, how does Harmony know a cult leader? No clue, but I'm planning on following them. Neko, you should come along. I'd love to have some support. He's still not talking to me after what I said. I can't blame him. What I said was awful. I just hope he won't snap and betray us. Wait, I'm coming! Shut off the power! Oh, hello. Welcome to Samada Hills Care Center. I'm Kimberly, your receptionist. Let me know if I can help you with anything. Top floor. All right, which room? Middle autumn? I have to go through all the rooms to figure out which one was his. Okay. How about middle top? Zzz, zzz. Hey kids, meet the director. Listen, you are a hit. People love you on TV. Would you mind coming back to the broadcast tower? We need to start filming the next episode right away. All right, we'll go ahead and do that in a moment. Not that room. Not that room. Not that room. Literally the last one. Are you crazy? I don't care how desperate I am. I'm not going to let you force inject some weird chemical into his bloodstream. It doesn't matter if we were friends. I'm not letting you touch him or any other patients here. You're a psychopath, a cultist. No way. Fine then. You can do it. Here's the vial. Analyze it. Do whatever you need to do to convince yourself it's safe. Maybe. Fine. Maybe I will. Do you know why we want to use your father, Harmony? Maldi was around during the original Delta incident in Hoenn. After Deoxys was defeated above Moss Deep City, people below started reporting strange fevers. Everything ended up being fine, but testing showed that everybody's DNA was slightly tainted. Not enough to be significant, but enough to be noticed if you look closely. My point is that Maldi's body may not react to viruses the same way as ours do. And there's one thing in particular I find interesting. Hold on a moment. This is just Pokerus. This isn't dangerous. We've known about this for years. Exactly. The Pokerus is very unique as infections go. It helps the Pokemon rather than hindering it. It allows them to grow stronger. In the scientific world, we call this mutalism. What you're holding right there is a strain that specifically increases the HP stat. Now, even though the virus doesn't affect ordinary people, it might be able to help your father. Increasing his HP stat could heal him, and even lengthen his lifespan. With some fine-tuning, we may even discover a path to immortality. What do you say, Harmony? This really is just Pokerus in a tube. How do I know you're not lying? Hiccup, sorry. How do I know you're not lying? You don't. I owe you, Harmony, and at the moment, our interests happen to cross. You want your father healed, and this could be a breakthrough for our cult's research. It's merely a business transaction. Your father's life, our goals. Not only that, but if it works on him, it may work on you as well. You're right about the DNA thing. He told me that a long time ago. I'm desperate enough to try it, but double-cross me, Ruka, and I swear, I'm glad to hear it. Let's just get this over with. Listen, I don't like needles. If you guys don't mind, I'm going to wait outside. Seriously? He's in the room with a cultist, and he's scared of needles. Hey, I don't like needles either! Anyways, okay, Dad, hang in there. 3, 2, 1... And done. I don't think it... Whoa, he jumped out of bed! Oh, you're awake. Are you okay? What's happening? Oh my Arceus, what the... Shh. Talk quietly. Be careful not to provoke him. Ryuka, what on earth did you do? This wasn't supposed to happen. I'm not sure. But he looks like a bit like Deoxys. I wonder if there's a connection. It makes sense. Deoxys is a virus known for its stats. Perhaps the Pokerus is an extension of this. You better fix him, Ryuka, or I'll... I think he's been healed at least. He should live longer too. The problem is that the virus may have impacted his mind somehow. It seems this experiment needs more fine-tuning. But anyways, we need to stay quiet. As long as we aren't loud, we can... Hey guys, how did it go? Did the needle go in okay? What an idiot. What have you done? This is your fault. This didn't quite go as planned, but what a breakthrough it's been. If he really is immortal now, then I'm sure we can find a way to use it without the drawbacks. Do you not care that someone was just kidnapped? What about my father? What did you do to him? Your father is fine. More than fine, in fact. He's the healthiest he's ever been. As for the poor, I'm sure he's fine. He may be infected, but the Pokoros helps, not hinders. My father would never do that. It's not really up to him at this point. And now is the time for me to take my leave. I have an appointment to keep with the gym leader. I hope you appreciate this. Your father is immortal now, after all. What a jerk. After all Sylvan and I did for him, you'd think he'd be a bit more appreciative. Damien. Listen, Nora, is it? We'll find your friend, I promise. Come with me, we'll try to figure out where Maldi took him.
I'd like that very much.
Neko, you can help us if you want, but you might find it more helpful to head to Kepler City. I'm worried that Ruka might be talking about Anastasia, the leader there, when he said that he had an appointment. If you could warn her that she might be in danger, I'd appreciate it. The other thing is Maldi. If you guys see him again, you have to let me know. We need to figure out a way to reverse this. For my own sake, I have to believe that it's possible. Come on, Nora, follow me. So, we just turned dear old dad into a Deoxys. Hey, everything got cleaned up. Sweet. That means I can go this way now. Route 10. Lovely. However, I don't want to do that yet. Isn't there a way south, too? No, it's just the horse races. I remember seeing something on my map. Yeah. Oh, it's the tracks. Okay. Sonata Hills. Route 10, and there's Kepler. Alright. I have a Pokemon that can... No, I don't have a Pokemon that can fly. However... Pika Taxi! Pika Taxi! Hi! Okay, and I think it was the Sky City? Mechi? Suntouched? Is that right? Midna, definitely not. Vipic, no. Mechi, I think it was Suntouched. Yes, Suntouched, and there's where I can go up. Come on, just climb on the thing! The directions are unresponsive sometimes. Okay, Radio Tower, I think, is this one. Welcome to the broadcast tower. Okay, so I just need to head over here, head up here, over here, and give a chat to you. Great work on your last mission, Neko. We have some information about a very rare Pokemon that's appeared in one of the many Torrin forests. We'd like you to check it out. But be warned, it can and will flee upon encountering it. Don't be alarmed if that happens. Be sure. We'll be sure to pay you extra. It's great to see you again. I'm sure the boss filled you in. We have some ancient grove of Pokemon. If we're lucky, we might find a really rare Pokemon here. Find it, challenge it to the bottle. You might not be able to catch it or even find it. Okay. Let's go ahead and save. So I am going to catch this. Oh my gosh! It's just gonna give me a Latios like this. Is that thing level freaking 90? I didn't even get a chance to fight it. We need to talk. We'll find a way to find that Latios again. It was incredible. I can't believe I got to see legendary Pokemon. This footage will sell for thousands. Here's your payment. 3 grand. We'll see if we can track where it went. And if we do, we'll be sure to call you again. So I'm going to get a Latios. A level 90 Latios. Come on, isn't that where I go down? Where do I go back down? I thought for sure that was it. So I'll grow the flowers here. I'm gonna go back in there. Well, that was a rather quick visit. Okay. Why didn't it work the first time? Whatever. Pika Taxi, bring me back to where we just were. And we were just over here. Can I still go to the Whirl Islands? He will take me to the Whirl Islands? Well, this definitely isn't where I want to be. I just wanted to see if it was actually something doable. Which, weirdly enough, it is. You know, I do want to do some research on something. Oh, wow, that got dark. Alright, let me get back to the town we were in and do a little bit of research, because there's something I really, really, really want to do. Alright, well, can't do what I wanted. I wanted the Delta Pikachu. But that is a bit further in. I have to beat the 6th gym, which, in all fairness, we did just beat number 5, and we're heading to number 6. So, we're on track. That's a broken lamp. Make sure I'm not missing anything, but at the same time, I really don't want to fight people. I just want to get across here as fast as I can. Okay. Big ocean of nothing. Come on, Wingle. Bug off. I guess fly off. Okay, what? Hello, Sharpedo. Not really interested in trying to figure something out. Oh, here we go. What do we have? Okay, just dead end. Fine. It looked like the path was going to go that way. Anything over here? Probably not. Just a dead end. That is a huge spot to surf in. Oh my gosh, Wingle! Go away! Okay, is this the city? This is! Welcome to Kepler. Let's go ahead and heal up. And let's head straight to the gym leader to give her a warning, I guess? Or are we gonna launch straight into a battle? I don't know. The heck? Why is there so much, like, junk? Tell me about the town. I see a lot of the abyssal cultists around these parts. There's also a really deep ocean trench just south of here. What a funny coincidence. Well, I know where they're staying. Lots of people. This is Anastasia's secret lab. I'm afraid I can't let you in. Access is restricted. Okay, there's got to be a way to get across those. Maybe not. Hi, Pika Taxi. That's the next road forward. Oh, hey. I missed what TM that was. Okay. Well, let's head straight to the gym. Okay, so that allows me to jump. That one doesn't. And there's no trainers here. So it's a dead end. So down this way, up this way. And she's not here. Lovely. So where do I find you, lady? Probably in here. Just a hunch. Anastasia's a great scientist, but she's always so busy. Between being a gym leader, a researcher, and an engineer, it's amazing she has any free time at all. Observatory of Kepler. We must record the trajectory of different celestial bodies. The back room is absolutely off limits, though only Anastasia and the two of us are allowed. Oof. Sorry, I didn't see you there. One moment, please. Dr. Rice, the telescope is completely fine. I don't know what you're talking about. There's a white glare in the middle of the image. It's clearly broken somehow. In the astronomy world, writes, we call that a star. That's not what... We'll talk about this later. If you spent less time on that project of yours and actually more research, writes, I said, later. And don't forget that that project of mine is funding us in the first place. Anyways, how can I help you? Oh, so you're a challenger. It's nice to meet you. I'm Anastasia. I run the gym here. My gym is based around machines. I specialize in both electric and steel types. I'll be glad to take you on. Harmony told you to warn me about the Perfection Cult. One of their lackeys might be coming after me. I see. Thank you for letting me know, but you don't need to worry. Let's just get going. I'm pretty busy at the moment. The sooner we can get this battle done, the better. What? The weather wasn't like this when I went into the building. This can't possibly be natural, but what kind of machine could possibly create this? Not a machine, Anastasia. A Pokemon. Audrey. How have you been, Anastasia? Alive. The world is changing. Our plan has been officially put into action. The storm is only the beginning. Soon my Lugias will... Storms will flood the entire world. Thought your group worshipped Kyogre. Oh, we do, believe me. But Kyogre's true value is only revealed in specific circumstances. These conditions are being created as we speak. Since leaders like you are too busy trying to save citizens, we can't be stopped. Tell me, Anastasia. Have you ever heard of... Thalassophobia. Describes mankind's innate fear of the deep, deep ocean. And soon, very soon, we'll be reminded where it came from. Well, that's fantastic. The worst part is, she's right. I can't stop her. I need to protect the people from the floods. But you... I'm not going to ask you to fight her. I can't ask that of some sort of kid. But if you could take this and find someone who could, I'd greatly appreciate it. Scuba gear! If she has Kyogre, then she must be in the deepest part of the ocean, and the only place like that is the Maelstrom 9. That scuba gear will let you dive down there. The Abyssal Cult is putting their plan into action, and now's the best time to end them. That's how it works in movies, right? Well, okay then. This isn't good. The entire city is flooded. Oh, now there's junk in the way. Alright, well, let's head down to... The heck? Oh, junk. Let's go take a dive! Oh, there are trainers down here. I just happened to miss them all. At least that looks like the top head of a trainer. Yep, okay. Wingles! Be gone! Love of... That's kind of cool. It's actually pretty, really cool. I'm really not in the mood to fight any of you, though. I'm kind of trying to do something kind of life-changing. What the heck? Okay. As long as I don't run into you and touch you, I think I should be fine. What is with those spots? Probably in here? The Abyssal Base. It's a force field that prohibits entry. Maybe only members can get in. Wait, I think it was... Thank you, Mew. Let me take this. Escape rope, good. One of these times I'm actually going to run into myself. Let's do a quick save. Oh hey, a battle? I'd love to, fellow cultist. Okay, so I can battle him still. Does it change my sprite? Oh, it doesn't even show me. Alright, Hypnosis. You suck. And I'll eat your dreams. Actually, you're water. Magical leaf. Oh my gosh, Poof is going to do amazing in here. That's not too horribly. Either way, be gone. You're not bad, you know. Oh, we got teleported. teleporters all over the place. This force field system is so complicated, one for field grunts, one for scientists, and one that only Audrey can get through. It hurts my brain just thinking about it. Why do you want to fight then? Alright, hey Swampert. You're gonna go to sleep. I need to find a move or an item that increases critical hits. Not increases critical hits, increases accuracy. Samurott. This is a steel and water, right? How does magical leaf work on you? Plenty well. Plenty well. Hang on just one moment. Second cut in the episode, I know. Okay. I actually know where I can go to get an item. It'll boost it by 10% of the original accuracy. I just want to see what Audrey's up to. So, with Poof, and that's not what I wanted. And Hypnosis having a 60% accuracy that only increases it by 6 to 66. Oh my gosh, I thought it was higher than that. Magical Leaf is really low too! No, that's the power. It will not miss, okay. Ouch. Okay, so I need to fill that with water. Nothing here. Hi there. Thank you. Sewer control system. Well, crap. Ultra Ball. Change of clothes. Abyssal Scientist DNA. Okay. Not like that. Okay, so a scientist can't go here. So I need to find a place that a scientist can go through. This spot, so let's try this one. I bet you I get a piece of Audrey's DNA at some point, too. It's a large piece of machinery. Oh, very, very helpful. Ice heal. Super potion. Map of the area. Something I can't access. Large piece of machinery. Password for the week? I'm pretty sure it's Proteus. Next time, remember when they tell it to you. Proteus. Okay. Is that Audrey? Okay, now I'm here. I can head over here to the keyboard. Proteos. Proteios. I should have been paying closer attention. Proteous? Or I-U-S? Proteus. Fine, whatever. Now I go back this way. Back this way. Up here. Now I come over here. Nope, not that one. Sea flare. Suppose cult leader Audrey. Which way was it? This way? No. Let's go through this one. Up here? No, that's the scientist. Okay, I just got lost. I just got like 300% lost. I teleported there. Oh, I'm such an idiot. It's over here. Did you know that 97% of the ocean is unexplored? It covers the majority of the planet, and we barely know anything about it. We know more about the moon than the seas on Earth. What kind of awesome Pokemon could exist down there? Have you heard of the Hoenn Calamity? About 30 years ago, when Kyogre was first summoned by Team Aqua, the weather went wild. Tons of things were raised from the depths of the ocean. Most of it was unimportant. Bottles, shoes, maybe a few gems or pearls. And a rare, never-before-seen Pokemon. A squid that looked similar to Tentacruel, but with vastly higher stats. An evolution. One that could only occur in high water pressure. A Pokemon with stats that rivaled legendaries. And further research shows that there are hundreds more. Of course, this was kept hush-hush. It would have been awful if everyone knew what creatures the ocean held. Everyone would be trying to catch these monstrosities, and with good reason. Fortunately, it turns out these Pokemon aren't nearly as strong out of the ocean as they are in it. Do you know why we're after Kyogre? It's incredibly powerful, and with a blue orb, it becomes one of the strongest Pokemon in the world. But do you know where its true talent lies? Kyogre is often considered as the deity of the sea, a real-life Poseidon. It's not an honorary title. Kyogre is the king in a most literal way. I'm not sure how, but it has the power to control and command other creatures of the sea. Sure, having Kyogre would be great, but having an entire army of deep-sea Pokemon, all with the strength of legendaries, would be undefeatable. And now we have Lugia on the surface, creating a storm to cover the world. With the surface flooded, my army will be stronger than ever. Kyogre is slowly calling forth the first of my beasts from the ocean even deeper than we are now. One by one, beast by beast, the abyssal occult will grow stronger. I couldn't start until today. Not until I had a power source strong enough to power both Kyogre and Lugia. But now I have a shard of the very same crystal that once powered the Augur. I've lost everything in pursuit of this goal. My life, my child, and more. So you've come to stop me? I'll take care of you now before the first creature rises. You won't stand a chance. Hi there. Go to sleep. Eat my magical leaf. Of course. Now go to sleep. Okay, it's a full heal? Where is that paralysis? It's gonna be a problem. Okay. Go to sleep. Let me eat your dreams. Good. Let's try magic relief. Okay, be gone. I assume she has a mega, a Ludicolo. Grass and water. I do want to switch out just because you're confused and it's going to cause some issues. You know what? Star Maker hasn't seen a lot of action in the last little bit. And I just realized how long this episode's going to become. Dragon Claw. Oh, that didn't do anything. Here comes your Kyogre. Dragon Claw. Oh, Ice Beam. That might hurt. That hurts a lot. Dragon is weak against ice. What do I have that would be good? Is Ground good against ice? Start with a Protect, make you waste a move. And Rock Slide? Don't kill, don't kill, don't kill. You know what, let's just go to Kudo. Mega Evolve. And we'll go with a Shadow Ball. Oh, that's why I didn't, that's why I didn't, that's why I didn't. Crap. Okay, I got you confused. I forgot, that's the entire reason I didn't do that. Kisa, can you hit a Thunderbolt? Okay. You hurt yourself in confusion? Holy crap, Kisa just took down a Kyogre. Holy crap! Oh! And I just slipped and kind of hit my foot. No, not my foot, my hand. No, we are not learning agility. A Kingdra. Okay, let's leave you in. I know you're gonna get hit, but it's kind of better to have you out now. Okay, poof. You're not confused anymore. I am actually really nervous. We're doing good. Magical Leaf I hit first. Okay, good, 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 good. Level 57, I am A-okay with that. Crawdaunt, which I think in this version has a Mega, so this could be her Mega. Yes. I think her Mega is what I already saw before. Ouch. And all that's left is Prince. Dang it, we were actually really close on this. Earth Power? That actually did a bit. Earth Power? And I'm sure I'm gone. Crap! I had a little bit of hope there for a moment. It's gonna put us back there. Alright, so I am going to go ahead and end the episode here. I hope you've all enjoyed this. If you have, please give me a thumbs up, give me some comments, let me know how I'm doing, some tips, ideas, and suggestions. And I'll see you all next time. Until then, bye-bye.